Hi, I'm Glenn. I'm here to do a tutorial on the 1962 Everly Brothers song called Crying in the Rain. It was written by David Coverdale and Howard Greenfield. And if you go to YouTube and look it up, the two main videos that you can find, one is just from their 1962 album and says something about Germany and Italy. It shows the young Don and Phil Everly on the cover in blue shirts. And that's the studio recording. Then there's another video that's worth watching that is them in later years. Obviously, they're older. You see a dark stage, and they're playing it live. And they do different introduction on that one than they do on the studio recording. In the studio recording, they started out in C, and they add a sixth note. That a sixth note, a sixth on the C chord, if you add them up, C, D, E, F, G, A. So A is the sixth in the key of C. And all they're doing is they're taking this middle finger and they're going down onto the third string or the G string and hitting the A note, which is second fret, third string. So it's a 4-4 song, so on the fourth beat of the measure, they're going down to that and adding that A note, okay? And then on the live version, they're doing it, instead of going to the A note, they're going actually to a G chord, which is like the fifth, the five chord. So it's like C, and then the fourth beat goes to G. A G chord. And you don't even have to play the whole G chord, you can just play the C and just hit the two bass notes in the G chord, which is fifth string, second fret, and sixth string, third fret, and just sort of keep your flat pick down around the lower strings as you make that little quick one beat change, like that. Now, as far as the flat picking pattern, they're basically playing mostly eighth note strums. It's a 4-4 song, four beats to a measure. But so if you think two strums for every beat mostly, that's how they're doing it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the simplest way to strum it is just all downstrokes. Two downstrokes for every beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that, okay? Actually, what they're doing is slightly more complex. On the fourth beat of the measure, they're actually doing a down, up, down, up. So they're doing like 16th beat strums that go like this. So it's, if we do that C to a G that they do live, they go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that, okay? But most of the song, to keep it simple for a new guitar player, somebody who's learning, you can do it all with downbeats if you want to, and it really keeps it a lot simpler, so you don't have to keep track of so much while you're trying to also remember the words and remember what chords to play, okay? And as you play more, you know, what'll happen is you'll become more intuitive about what you do with your right hand, and you don't have to think about patterns, strumming patterns, quite so much. Or you can memorize strumming patterns, and after a while, they become sort of second nature, okay? So I'm going to play through the song now and let you see, you know, close-up views of my fingers and my right-hand strumming pattern and what I'm doing. So here we go.
Never let you see my broken heart is hurting me. I got my pride and I know how to hide all my sorrow and pain. I'll do my crying in the rain. If I wait for cloudy skies, you won't know the rain from the tears in my eyes. You'll never know that I still love you so, though the heartaches remain. I'll do my crying in the rain. Raindrops falling from heaven could never wash away my misery. But since we're not together, I look for stormy weather to hide these tears I hope you'll never see. Someday when my crying's done, I'm gonna wear a smile and walk in the sun. I may be a fool, but till then darling, you'll never see me complain. I'll do my crying in the rain. Raindrops falling from heaven could never wash away my misery. But since we're not together, I look for stormy weather to hide these tears I hope you never see. Someday when my crying's done, I'm gonna wear a smile and walk in the sun. I may be a fool, but till then, darling, you'll never see. Crying in the rain. I'll do my crying in the rain. I'll do my crying in the rain.
Okay. Now, again, the flat picking pattern can vary all over the place, but if you want to keep it simple, you can just play eighth beat downstrokes. I'll never let you see the way my broken heart is hurting me. I got my pride and I know how to hide my sorrow and pain. I'll do my crying in the rain. Okay, so that keeps the downstroke stuff, I mean the flat picking part, simple, I think. Now, you know, as I said, you can do down up, you know, when it seems convenient. So, like, you know, you could play that
I'll never let you see the way my broken heart is hurting me. I got my pride and I know how to hide all the sorrow and pain. I'll do my crying in the rain.
Okay. So what did I do?
I'll never let you see.
Okay, so I on C, I'm going down, up, down, up.
the way my broken heart is hurting me. I got my pride and I know how to hide all my sorrow and pain. I'll do my crying in the rain.
Just real quick, this is a nylon Dunlop 1 millimeter flat pick. It's about as thin a pick as I use. And I just, I just keep my wrist kind of flexible. So that's a little bit of background. There's an F chord in here. For beginners who hate F chords, you know, because you can play it as a bar chord as I'm playing it, basically it's an E configuration like down here, and then go up one fret and bar it. That's an F. But for a new guitar player who doesn't want to deal with bar chords at that the stage of your playing, you can play the highest four strings this way. Use your first index finger to hit the first and second strings on the first fret. Use your middle finger to hit the third string, second fret, and your ring finger to hit the fourth string, third fret, right? And just don't play these two lower ones. And it doesn't lose you that much if I play it that way.
I'll never let you see.
So I don't think you can hear the difference that much. The way I play a G may confuse you. I do an awful lot of playing a G with all four fingers like this. The normal way to play a G is like this. Middle finger on the fifth string, second fret, ring finger, sixth string, third fret, little finger, first string, third fret. But I like to add this D note onto a G chord here. And so that's why I play it this way. I don't always do that, so then I leave that open. But sometimes I want to. So like when I'm doing that G and just holding it, I tend to add that D string.
I'll do my crying in the rain.
Anyway. So I hope that's helpful, and I don't think I need to belabor this too much more, but you got the chords, and you can hear how it's sung, even though I'm not, you know, going crazy about what I sound like right now, just because it's an instruction, and what to do with your right hand. I hope this helps. Thank you.